Hello everyone, I'm Sushmita Sarkar from RV College of Engineering. I welcome all of you for lecture 6 in Power System Analysis 2 course, in which I'm handling module 1. So we have seen in our last lecture that formation of Y-bus by singular transformation method, but in the last classes we have not considered with the lines which are not coupled with each other. So today's lecture we'll see the formation of Y-bus for mutual coupling transmission lines by using the same method, which is singular transformation method. Okay, so first, before we start, we have to understand what is the meaning of mutual coupling between transmission lines. Fine, so what does it mean? So I'm just explaining you that concept with the help of two transmission lines. Fine, so the line, transmission lines will have, once they get energized, they generate their own self magnetic field. Fine, so that magnetic field will be getting affected by the nearby or the parallel lines magnetic field. Hence, we say that the two lines are mutually coupled, and this results into induce of zero sequence voltage and current in both the lines. Fine, so now when we are doing this particular, in this particular equivalent circuit, we see that ZS1 and ZS2 are the line series impedances, and ZM is the mutual impedance between both the lines. Fine, so now we are going to forward with the expressions by taking one assumption that we are not considering the shunt elements into picture. Fine, so now you see the voltages VI and VJ are the respective voltage of the first transmission line with respect to the ground, and VK and VL are the two end voltages of the second line. Fine. Similarly, you can see the current which is flowing from I to J is not same as current which is flowing from J to I. If it happens so, then you have no transmission losses in the system. Fine, which is not possible because we know there will be always a voltage drop in the transmission line. Fine, so now if I write down the equation of the first line VI, so the equation, how it will be? It will be the impedance of that line with the multiply of that particular current. Then what do you have? The mutual impedance, because this is giving you the self-excited generated EMF. This is giving you the mutually, okay, induced EMF. So this is coming the mutual inductance with that opposite, because this magnetic field current comes into the picture due to the effect of the current in the parallel line. Okay, so the current in the parallel line was IK plus the voltage at the other end. Similarly, I'll be writing the same equation for the second line. So when I write these equation in these two format, so I can put it in a matrix form. So what do you see? The VI and VK over here, that is a one end of the voltage, and this is the another end of the voltage. So difference between both the end basically talks about the voltage drop in the transmission line, which I am putting in a matrix form. I hope this particular matrix equation is clear to all of you. Fine, so if you just write down the equation, you will get back the same first two equations over here. Fine, so now I can write the equation in this way, or I can also put the equation in admittance form. So this is the equation in form of impedance. The same equation, if you want to put it in the form of admittance, then this is the equation down over here. Now, how do I get these equations? Fine, so now I'm just writing the equations back over here in case of an admittance form. So basically, if you have the admittance, the inverse of this will give you the impedance. Okay, so basically one thing all of you remember, in case of a mutual coupling problem, first we take the Z primitive. Okay, so first we do with the Z primitive, then we take the inverse of the Z primitive as a Y primitive, and then you use the same formula for a singular transformation method, which says A transpose multiplied by Y primitive multiplied by A matrix, which is a bus incidence matrix. Fine, I repeat, for mutual coupling problem, first we write down the Z primitive matrix, then we take the inverse of the Z primitive matrix, we get the Y primitive matrix, and that we use it for our Y bus equation for a singular transformation method. And once you get the complete Y bus of that particular system, you can take the inverse of that and get the Z bus of the same system. Fine, so there is a different way of doing it. So next, Let us understand this concept by taking a very simple problem. So basically, I'll be taking a two transmission lines which are mutually coupled with each other. So you can see there are three buses, and there are two lines, both are having the same line impedances, and their mutually coupled impedance is given as J.15. So now I'll be writing first a Z primitive matrix. So you know the primitive matrix is usually a diagonal matrix. Then how the primitive matrix looks different when the lines are becoming mutual couplings. I hope all of you remember in my previous lecture, I told you very clearly that the primitive matrices will be diagonal only if there are no mutual coupling present in any one of the transmissions line. Fine. So now if it happens so, then how does my primitive network looks like? It is no more going to be only a diagonal elements. The off diagonal elements of those two particular lines will be present where the mutual coupling exists. Fine, so let us see. So now you have only two lines. So it is actually a Z primitive which shows the diagonal elements. This is a first element J.25 and this is a diagonal element J.25. If the same problem if we don't consider the mutual coupling, then these two would have been zero. Fine, now there is a mutual coupling present over here, and you have seen in your previous equation that the mutual coupling affects your off diagonal elements. Fine, so now your off diagonal value will be, this will be Zm and this will be Zm. So this is your Zs1, which we have shown in the previous slides. I'll just go back. So you can see this is your Zs1, Zs2, Zm and Zm. Fine, so here you can see it in the same way. So now I will be taking the inverse of this matrix to get the YPR. Fine, so you take the inverse of Z primitive. This gives you a Y primitive matrix. Then after that, you all of you know the solution. How do we do it? We multiply with A transpose and A to get the Y bus if we want to do it with the help of singular transformation method, okay? And so you just go through this. Now you can see it, that Y bus is equal to A, and A matrix, incidence matrix, all of you know, we have already studied in our previous lectures. We have learned that how to form an A matrix. So since here you have two simple lines, so basically you get an identity matrix in this particular network. So this is your A transpose will be equal to A only. Fine, so after multiplying this, I get back the same answer because my A transpose and A are simple say that my A matrix is an identity matrix. So the transpose of that matrix also going to be identity. So your Y bus is nothing but your Y primitive value will get back. So that this was a simple example to make you understand that how do you solve a Y bus when your transmission lines are mutually coupled. So now let us take one more problem where I have more number of transmission lines and the mutual coupling is present only between few lines. Fine, so problem two. So here you can see for the network shown, form the primitive matrices Z and Y and obtain the bus admittance matrix by singular transformation. The data is given below. Fine, so this is the graph of the network given and the data of the network given over here. So now what does it say? That is, this is my the elements or the line numbers. So you can see the line number two. So line number two is over here. And this is your line number one. So line number two is mutually coupled with line number one. So basically, let me represent with this. So basically I'm telling these two line numbers, okay, these two line numbers, line two and line one, these two are mutually coupled with the value of J.1, okay? With the value of J.1. This is between these two lines and the value is J.1, okay? Similarly, line number four is mutually coupled with line number one, fine, with a value of J.2. So that means these two lines, this line and this line, these two lines are mutually coupled with each other with a value of J.2. So how do we solve such kind of problems? Fine. So now first thing, as I have told you, the very first step is to make the Z primitives. So my dear students, so you know, if the mutual coupling are not present, the same line Y1, Y2, Y3, Y4, Y5 will be diagonal matrix. So similar way, you just first put all the values diagonally in your ZPR also. And off diagonal elements will be present only between 1, 2, 2, 1 and 1, 4 and 4, 1, because your mutual coupling is between 1 and 2, 1 and 2 and 1 and 4. Okay, between only these two lines, you have a mutual coupling. So only those particular respective off diagonal elements will have these particular mutual coupling values Zm. So let us see. Fine. So I have written the first A matrix for that particular graph. So I hope all of you know how to do it. So please try it out and we'll see how do we get that graph. Fine. So you here, you are taking the node one as a reference. So go back. So if you take the node one as a reference, this is your reference. So basically, I just clear this particular screen. Fine. So I'm clearing the screen. So my this bus is taken as a reference. So this bus is connected to line number 3. So you know when one of the existing bus is considered as a reference, then your size of A matrix is going to be element cross number of buses. So you have 5 elements. So it will be 5x3 matrix. First, you should have an idea of the size of the matrix. Then you will not go wrong. So your size of A matrix is going to be 5x3 because the bus one is your reference bus and it will not be a part of your A matrix. Fine. So now here you can see the element number 1, element number 4, and element number 2. Fine. Element number 1, element number 4, element number 2 are away from this. So that will be positive. So the respective for the node 2, it will be negative. So based on that only, we have written it. Fine. So the other two things were towards it. So it will be negative. The other part will be positive. So you get it as. So you can see here, we take it as this particular first three. Why did you got it like this? This depends on, I told you, please take care of branch and link. Fine. So if we go back, fine. So if we go back, so the branch and link would have, the tree would have been 1, 2, and 3. Fine. The tree would have been the element number 1, element number 2, and element number 3 is your tree. Element number 4 and element number 5 you have taken as a link. Okay. So your element number 1, which you'll be getting as -1, because it's towards the 2, this also will become -1. But in case of a 3 and 4, the 3 will be +1 and 4 will be -1. Okay, so you can see 3 is, this is your 2, 3 and 4. The numbering will be over here is your 2, 3 and 4, as number 1 is your reference. Remember, one number 1 is your reference. So your this column will be 2, 3, 4. And here we have made a tree with 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay. So we have, okay, so this is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. This is your A matrix. So you can see the number first element is between the 0 and bus number 2. So if you want to cross check, go back. Fine. The first element is between, this is your first element is between the reference bus and the second bus. So it is towards the second bus. So it is -1. Number 2, it's towards the third bus. It is -1. Fine. So if you go back like this, this is second, first element is between reference and second bus. So it is -1. Second element is between reference and third bus. So reference is gone. That is away from the reference bus, positive, towards the third bus. This is your negative. The number 3 element is between the third bus and the fourth bus. So it is away from 3, it is positive. It is towards the 4, it is -1. So please keep it in mind that you have to keep the branches first and the link next. Okay. But if it is not mentioned that for a particular problem, which elements you should take it as a tree or which you should take it as a link, you can take your own tree, but keep it in mind, the numbering should be same. The order of the element first should be the branches, then should be the link. And the same order should be also maintained for your Y primitive. Otherwise, definitely you will end up to get a wrong answer. Fine. So now similar way, I'll be finding out the Z primitive. So Z primitive, all of you can notice, this is your, all diagonal elements are your, the value of the line. the individual line, all the five lines, these are the data given in your question. So you're diagonally putting it. Now I have a mutual coupling between 1 and 2, and I have a mutual coupling between 1 and 4. Fine. So the, as per the question, the mutual coupling is between 1 and 2 and 1 and 4, and 1 and 2 is having a value of J.1, and 1 and 4 is having a value of J.2. So you can check it out over here. These particular positions will have these two values. So here your 1, 2 position is this one. This is your 1, 2 position. So this is J.1, and this is your 1, 4 position. So this is J.2. Similarly, it's a symmetrical matrix. So here also, this is your, okay, this is your 2, 1, and definitely, okay, so this is always giving problem. Okay, so I'll just, so this is your 2, 1, because 1, 2 is going to be 2, 1, and 1, 4 is going to be 4, 1, same. So only those particular off-diagonal elements are going to be present in your Z primitive. So this is basically your Z primitive, and the inverse of this Z primitive will give you an Y primitive. So that is the inverse of your Z primitive. You get it as Y primitive value. Okay. So now with the, once you know the Y primitive, all of you know how to do it. The Y bus, that is your A transpose Y into A, and you get this particular answer. So all of you please try and see that how do you solve from Y primitive, from Z primitive, taking inverse to Y primitive and coming back to your Y bus by singular transformation method. I hope all of you have understood this particular concept of mutual coupling in may way of making formation of Y bus using singular transformation method. And please try to solve more number of problems to understand the concept in much more better way. Thank you. Have a nice day.